Joining me live now is lawyer and lobbyist Nathan Daschle, who used to be the executive director of the Democratic Governors Association. Nathan, good to see you. A second assassination attempt. I mean, it just beggars belief, doesn't it? But Donald Trump there, it's given him a bit of energy, I think.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if it will actually change Donald Trump's numbers very much. But look, the assassination attempt itself was sad, it was scary, and it's maddening. And an assassination attempt, an attack on a presidential candidate, is an attack on the country, and it's an attack on all of us. Now, I do believe that those who say that the political rhetoric of the United States has gotten too extreme, it's gotten too polarizing, and we try to make enemies of the other side, and that much has got to stop. But that's really a responsibility on all of us. It's not a responsibility in one party more than the other. It's a responsibility of us as voters, the elected officials, and everyone who takes part in the process.
Yeah, it certainly does. But Nathan, when do you think the turning point was? I feel like it happened quite a way back. And if you look at America's history, I mean, there is no shortage of assassinations that have been successful and attempted ones as well. But I think with Donald Trump in the fray, things have really stepped up. Now, he's both victim and perpetrator there, and language matters. But do you think there is a point that he has, the Democrats calling him the most dangerous politician of his time, etc.?
Well, I don't. I think that we have suffered from intense polarization for quite some time. But I think that you're right that it got a lot worse in 2016 when Donald Trump came on the scene. And he fires up both sides. He fires up his own supporters and those who oppose him. And the rhetoric, the violent rhetoric, there's a lot that comes from Trump. I mean, on January 6th, when his supporters were saying, hang Mike Pence, he refused to tell them to stop or to back down. So that's why I say that it's a responsibility that that both sides and everyone in the middle has to take on. We all have to assume the responsibility for a healthy and productive debate in the United States.
Yeah, and that hasn't been productive or healthy for quite some time. Yeah. It is changing. Well, you know, the debate I thought was pretty civil between Kamala Harris and Donald Trump, even though I think she was the better communicator. So we're not going to see another debate there. But does that kind of thing, you know, elevate the political debate, take the temperature out of it a bit?
I do think that the one good outcome from something like this, something as sad and tragic as this, is that it does bring both sides together to recognize that that we all need to be sensitive to the quality of our debate. And, you know, as former President Trump indicated, he spoke with both Biden and Vice President Harris in the wake of this. And there are rare times when the two parties come together, but there is one at this moment where both parties are coming together to denounce political violence in all forms.
Yeah, Nathan, it is a fascinating race, and I wouldn't have thought there would be a second assassination attempt on Donald Trump when we spoke last week, but here we are. There's a long way to go to November 5. We'll check in with you soon.
All right, thanks so much.